Hey guys, welcome and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing a makeup tutorial for you guys. It is going to be something along the lines of a black smoky eye. Usually when I do my makeup, I just go with whatever I'm feeling, and I don't think I've done a smoky eye look in a while, especially a black one. So if you would like to see that, then let's get started. So as you can see, I've already applied my foundation and I've done a little bit of contouring. I worked on my eyebrows a little bit and I have set underneath my eyes for the fallout. I'm going to go ahead and get my contour color, which I use the Black Radiance powder. This one is in Ebony. That's what I have done all my contouring with, and I'm also going to contour around my eyes. So that's where we're going to begin. I just want to do a little bit of contouring here, and then I'm also going to extend this down to my nose. Shading in this area makes a huge difference, like how your makeup turns out. It gives it like a dramatic effect, but then also enhances your eye. And I'm also going to drag a little bit of this into my transition area. Right in here, right in my crease. And I like to place it, but then also do a little bit of swirling in here, because this is gonna soften it up, make it very soft. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and work on my nose. I'm just gonna lightly drag this down on the sides. I'm doing this very lightly because the brush that I'm using, I believe it's a Sonia Akashic, one of the limited editions. It doesn't have like a particular name, but it, as you can see, is very wide and it's pretty dense, but then it also disperses outward. So I want to be careful when using this, like in the, well, I would suggest be careful because of it can cause like your contour lines to blow out. And the reason why I like to use this brush is because it gives like a soft diffuse look. I'm going to get this along the bottom and I'm going to join the two together, the two lines. Some people like to do it right here, just draw a little soft line, and that's going to make your nose a little bit rounder. I normally just do straight down and bring them together at the bottom. And then I also like to grab a pencil brush. This is a Dillion Tools 780, and I like to darken it around the outer part of my nose. This is going to keep my nose from looking flat whenever I take a photo. And that's going to be it for that. So let's go ahead and move on to the eye look. So I'm going to grab my MAC Painpot. Looks like this. This one is in Groundwork. And I am going to apply that to my mobile lid. This is going to be the start or the base of the smoky eye. I'm looking for a synthetic brush, but I'll just go ahead and use this one. This one I was going to use to lay down the glitter, but we can do this, well, we can use this as well to apply the base. I'm just lightly tapping and dragging it. It doesn't have to be super pigmented. I just need something for the eyeshadows to stick to. I'm gonna flip the brush over and try to diffuse this because I don't want it to dry down into a harsh line. I'm gonna flip it back over and just continue to work on this smoky eye. Okay, so that's good enough for now. I'm gonna work on the other side as well. Same thing. Trying to get as close to the lash line as possible, just lightly grazing over the area. Okay, now we also with doing this, we also kind of build our shape. So what I'm going to do right now is get a transition color. I like to go with something in the pink tone, berry tone, for a transition shade. Sometimes I do red or sometimes orange. It all depends, but today I think I'm going to do something in the pink family. Let me find a color that I want to use. I think I'm going to utilize the festival palette by Juvia's Place. It looks like this, and there's a pink in here. I think I'm gonna go with this one. It is called Irie G. Hopefully you guys can see that, and that is what I'm going to use as my transition shade. So I'm going to go ahead and grab my MAC 17. Actually, 217. I don't know where it is. Here it is. I'm going to dip my brush in there. Just going to pack the color. I think I have like an eyelash poking me in my eye. Just like that. And I'm just going to pack this color down along the edges. Go ahead and be pretty heavy-handed with this. I want this to be a pretty dramatic smoky eye. Same thing to the other side. Just packing the color down, building the intensity. One more to the other side. Then I'm going to go ahead and start blending this. I'm just going to turn the brush over and just lightly soften this edge. I'm going to flip the brush back around and just put a little bit of pigment right here. I'm going to flip it back. And let's just diffuse the edges again. I don't want any harsh lines. I'm going to do is grab my black eyeshadow. This one kind of looks a little bit on the charcoal side, but that's okay. It's out of the same palette, and it's going to be this shade right here. Keleke. I believe that's how you pronounce it. So I'm just going to go ahead and use the same brush that I used to pack down the paint pot. And this is going to be our smoky eye color. I'm just going to press this down. I'm just going to keep packing this color down. And I'm going to slightly work my way up. You don't have to go up, but I don't have that much mobile space with my eye open. So I like to extend it a little bit into my crease. So that way when my eyes are open, you can see my shadows. Just packing it down. If you want, you can wing it out. I think I might do that. I don't do that often in videos. So I think that's what I'll do this time. So let me get an angle brush. I'm going to be utilizing this brush. I believe I got it from Coastal Scents years ago. It doesn't have anything on it. I'm just going to dip my brush in that. And I'm going to wing out the outer corner. Just lightly. Same thing for the other side. I'm going to go ahead and grab my 217 that had the pink tone on it, and I'm just going to go over this, diffuse this. I'm actually going to go ahead and wipe off the 217, try to get off as much color as possible, and I'm going to use it to blend this outer portion out. It's a little bit harsher than what I want it to be. This side is okay, but this side is the one that I need to work on. So what I'm going to do to try to diffuse this or correct this area, I'm going to grab my All Over Face powder. I'm just going to tap it up there and try to soften it. But if that doesn't work, it's okay. I feel like a smoky eye can be kind of messy. I'm just wiping it off as I go. Because I don't want to add anything to this outer part. But what I think I'm going to have to end up doing is just go back in with my foundation to correct the edges. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and do that before I move on. I'm just going to put a little bit of my foundation in the back of my hand. And this is the Revlon Colorstay in the shade Cinnamon 600. I'm going to grab a low Cornell. This is from the paintbrush section in like a craft store. I believe I got this out of Hobby Lobby. I've had this for a while. I don't know if they still sell them. But you can use an angler paintbrush. And what I'm going to do is just sharpen this. And then just cover what I do not want. Just like that. I might have to go back and fix this and set it with powder, but for right now, I need to get my lines right so that I can continue on. I'm gonna do the same thing for the other side. Need a little bit more foundation. Now what I'm checking for to see if they're pretty even. I think I'm okay with the look that I have right now. So I'm just going to wipe off a little bit of this foundation that I have. I don't want that to get anywhere else as we're working. So I'm going to go ahead and grab my 217 again. I'm going to wipe it off pretty well because I have pink and black on the brush now, and I don't want the black to get where I don't want it. So, because right now I'm going to go ahead and go back into the pink. I'm just going to lightly place it back because I feel like I lost some of the color. And I'm also going to grab a pretty dense brush. This is a double-sided Laura Geller brush. It doesn't have a particular name, but I'm going to put down a shade underneath my brow bone. And I'm going to go in the same palette, and I'm going to utilize this shade. I don't know how to pronounce it, so I'll just show it to you. And that's the one that I'm going to put down right here underneath my brow bone. Two seventeen again, and then I blend the two together. Okay, so now I'm going to go ahead and start working on the glitter portion of this tutorial. I pulled out some hard candy. This is called Showgirl Secret Glitter Glue. I haven't used this in a while. I don't know if it's still available, but you can just use what you have. I'm going to put a little bit of this in a cap, and that's what I'm going to use to dip my brush in. That way I can apply the glitter. So I'm going to go ahead and grab the brush that I used to apply my base for my eyeshadow and the actual eyeshadow. I'm going to dip it into the glitter glue mixture, and I am going to apply that to my lid. Just going to lightly tap it. Then I'm going to grab my glitters that I got from Hobby Lobby some time ago. I don't know if they're still available. But I'm going to use this first one right here, and this is the one that has like the blacks. And that's the color that I'm going to use. Actually, I'm going to get the Smokey one. So let me put it back together. because I think it'll go better with this look. So it's going to be like this smoky charcoal color right here, the second one. It's hard trying to get this top off. It's so small. Okay. Got it off without spilling it. This has hints of blue in it, which is kind of in the direction like the eyeshadow color is itself. So I'm just going to press this right on top of that glitter glue. This is so pretty. It has a reflex of like a purple tone to it as well. It goes really well with the colors that I have down. Okay, now I'm going to work on the other side. My brush is still damp, so it should be tacky enough for me to just move to the other eye. I'm just gonna keep packing this glitter down until I get the intensity I want. Hopefully it's showing up on camera. I've been having trouble with that. It seems like whenever I do a makeup tutorial, that in person it is really intense, but then when I look at it on camera, it seems like the intensity of the eyeshadows get lost. I'm not really sure how to fix that. I'm not really a high-tech person like that. Like, know that much about cameras or photography. So if anybody knows what I can do to fix that, I would appreciate it. I use my phone and I have a Note 10 Plus. I'm very happy with that. I'm not gonna extend it on the wing. Just here. Okay, so what I'm gonna do right now is grab an eyeliner. I'm going to be using this Revlon Colorstay Skinny liquid eyeliner. Looks like this, and it is in black, and I'm going to actually line or make a wing. I'm gonna make it pretty intense. I'm just going to do a thin line on the front. Okay, same thing to the other side. I think I'm pretty happy with this. I just feel like I need a little bit more glitter, like right in here. So that there's more than other, well, more than one on, or enough on the other side. So I just need to pack a little bit more color down to match it. So like there's more glitter right in here. There we go. I'm just gonna go over and add more glitter. And I think I'm going to find a color for my inner corner. Now I'm also going to smoke out my lower lash line. Sorry you guys today. I just feel like I was in the mood, like such in a mood, a good mood to record a video. And it just seems like, I don't know. Like what I'm trying to say is like not coming out the way I want it to. It's not flowing. But we're just going to go ahead and go with the flow. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is dust off. I'll wipe off this brush, dust off this fallout. I'm going to fix this right here. Like it's like got that line, you have something skips, and that's what it was looking like. I don't know if it was picking up, but I'm gonna try to darken the shape on the outer V. There we go. See that? See the difference? Same thing for the other side, just want to deepen it up. Okay, so now I'm going to move to the lower lash line. I am going to grab this pencil right here. This is the L'Oreal Voluminous Smoldering Eyeliner. And I'm going to line my waterline with it. Eyelashes are doing something crazy today. I can feel them poking in my eye. That's why I need to move a little bit of glitter, because I don't want that to get in my eye. There we go. Hopefully you guys can see. I'm just going to run a thin line just to make this area dark in my waterline. And then it's also going to be the base for the charcoal black color. I'm just going to drag it down a little bit, give it something to stick to. I normally don't do a line that's too thick right in here, because it makes my eyes look smaller, but I'm gonna make the lines even. Drag it in here. You wanna make sure you connect right in here so that your top and your bottom connects. So I'm going to widen this line up a little bit right in here. Okay, I'm pretty happy with that. So I'm going to grab a brush. I believe this, it says Coastal Scents. I don't even think Coastal Scents is in operation anymore, but it's a 253. I'm going to use this brush to pack down the shadow on my lower lash line. How many minutes am I on? Oh boy. I'm just so slow doing my makeup. I just take my time. And if I feel like I don't have the time to do it, I just won't even bother to do it. Once again, make sure you connect it. This brush is pretty dense. So what I'm going to do is grab a pencil brush that's a bit softer. It looks like this. This is a Dillium Tools 780. And I'm going to go over the line that I just put down because this is going to diffuse it. Okay, so now I need to decide on what I want to do for an inner corner highlight. I'm trying to debate on if I want to do something colorful or just kind of do something that goes with this. Because the glitter is giving off a purple tone. Let me see. I think that would be pretty with it. I have a couple new palettes. That's what I'm looking at right now. This one is the Wahala 2 palette. Looks like this on the inside. I'll probably be using these in some upcoming tutorials. And then I went ahead and bought the Culture palette. And it looks like this on the inside. And I believe I'm going to use something out of the Voila palette. There's a color that is calling my name. And it's called Fake, right here. It's not really showing up. Like, it's really not that violet, magenta type color in person. It's showing up, I mean, not in person, but on camera. It's showing up very vibrant on camera. But it's like a, like a color shifting type of shade. But it's in the pink, or it has a bit of pink. I see a bit of copper and a bit of purple in it. That's the best way for me to describe it. But I'm gonna get that color and I'm going to put it in the inner corners. Just like that. I think I'm gonna wet my brush as well because I'll make this pretty intense. I'll just use what I have left to wet my brush for the glitter glue. I'm also going to drag it down slightly on the lower portion. You see that? I feel like this one needs to be a little bit more intense. So I'm keep packing the color down. Okay, I'm pretty happy with that. So I'm just going to go ahead and clean up around those areas. I'm going to grab my all-over face powder. And I'm just going to clean up. I might have to go back over my nose contour after I do that, but that's okay. Got a little bit of fallout on my nose. So I'm just gonna redo my nose contour. To prevent that, you could just leave the powder on, but I had took it off a little bit too early. I was just kind of correcting some things that I wasn't fond of. Now I'm going to go back and use my brush that I used for my contour, and I'm just going to redo my contour. To grab my all over face powder. I'm going to get another brush that's similar to the one I just used. I'm just going to drag it down the center. Grab the contour brush again and just diffuse it. That's what I do when I kind of get a little bit of eyeshadow that I might have blown over onto my nose. Instead of just starting over and try to put like liquid products, I try to correct it as much as possible with my powder. For the most part, it works. I'm able to fix it easily. I'm just gonna put a little bit more right in here. And that's gonna be it for that. What I'm going to do is just go ahead and retouch up my eyebrows. Push them up, and then I'm going to go ahead and put a little bit of clear mascara on them. I might actually just darken them a little bit. I was going to use just this shape. I've already done something to my eyebrows, but being that this look is pretty intense, I feel like I need to intensify my eyebrows a little bit more, just deepen them. I like to start like right in here. I'm just going to outline what I have, just like that. Same thing for the other side. I'm not really pressing hard, just lightly pressing, feather-like strokes. Like that. This one I'm going to add a little bit more color. And always, you guys, like I said earlier, I'm really slow when, you know, I take my time when I do my makeup videos. It's just my thing. You're always welcome to fast forward to the parts that you want to see. So now I'm going to take my spoolie and I'm going to drag it through this to soften up these lines. Just like that. It gives it more of a natural look. I'm just gonna really drag it through. Same thing to the other side. So I have originally planned to do a red lip, but this seems to be leaning more up towards a berry pinky type shade, purple. So I'm gonna have to change what lip color I had planned for this look, which is fine. I still like how it turned out. So now what I'm gonna do is just go ahead and grab my mascara, some clear mascara that I got from Wet n Wild. And I'm just gonna run it through. I like to brush the front up. Just like so. Okay, you guys, so I am going to grab, I think I'm going to use this pinky tone right here as my blush. Just keep everything in the same family, that way it's easy and it's cohesive. I think my original brush that I used for my my blush is dirty, my favorite brush, so I'm just going to use this brush right here. I got this from Walmart. It's one of those like Walmart gift sets for during Christmas time that they have out, and it just says angle brush. I don't even remember what the name is, but I'm going to use that because it has a lot of bristles, but it's also easy to diffuse. It's not going to just pack the color down and then it's just stuck in that spot. I need something to fan this out just like this. I'm going to start the apples in my cheeks. Drag it back towards the hairline. I'm going to pack down a little bit more than usual, be a little bit heavy-handed with the blush. I feel like this look can carry it off. It's pretty intense. So at this point, what I'm going to do is I'm going to figure out what kind of eyelashes that I want to use, since it's a little bit of a change of plans, and the ones that I had in mind, I don't think they're going to be enough volume for this look. So I need to figure that out, and what kind of lip color that I'm going to be using. So I'll be back. Hey you guys, I am back. I went ahead and got dressed. I did put on some lashes, and the lashes that I'm going to be using today are these. These I Envy, and this is KPE 139, right here where the lashes come off. It says Glam 3D and the number 39. And that's what they look like. Very pretty. I got them at Walmart. And for my lips, I used this Covergirl Full Spectrum. This is in the shade Bossy. It's a berry purple color. I was going to put lip gloss on it, but I don't have anything exactly this shade. So I didn't want to alter this color because it's really pretty. And I lined my lips with this. This is the Ruby Kisses Ultra Easy Lip Liner. And this is in shade Mauve. That's what I use for my lip liner. And that is going to be it for the final look, you guys. I hope you guys like this tutorial. And be safe. God bless. And I'll see you.